You're watching True Crime Coverage with Angela Renee. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and go ahead and hit that notification bell. Please share my content if you care. I appreciate you. Let's get started. Hey guys, so today I'm going to cover a topic that's much lighter than one of my typical topics. So today I'm going to be talking about fraud and one half of the Clermont Twins duo. If you don't know the Clermont Twins, they first gained popularity on Oxygen's reality series, The Bad Girls Club. The twins were also Yeezy 6 runway models. They dressed as lookalikes of Kim Kardashian West. The duo was notorious on the BGC for their explosive tempers, cruel shade, and bougie attitudes. Viewers were almost guaranteed to see either one or both of the Clermont twins involved in beef, verbal attacks, and/or physical attacks with their castmates.
Shannon,
I'm Shannade,
and we're the Clermont twins.
If you look up bad bitch in the dictionary, you'll find the Clermont twins.
Yeah.
You'll find me and
two
Shannon.
Bad bitches.
Right.
Speaking of bad issues and bad girl behavior, on July 11th of 2018, Shannade Clermont, who was 24 years old at the time, was arrested after stealing a dead man's debit card information after meeting him for a prostitution date and racking up tens of thousands of dollars in fraudulent charges. So guys, Shannade agreed to meet a 42-year-old real estate broker, James Alesi, at his Manhattan apartment the evening of January 31st of 2017. Now, he requested her companionship for the night, and she charged him $400.
Everybody wants this cookie, my spoil your rotten cookie. Everybody wants this cookie, my spoil your.
Shannade created several email addresses, including one with the username XXXExoticDialXXX, which was used to solicit dates for prostitution. Shannade arrived at James' apartment, and she noticed that he was, quote unquote, a drunk mess. She thought he was just playing games, so she left his place, but not before taking his debit card. The day after their date, James was found dead in his 53rd Street apartment from an overdose of cocaine mixed with fentanyl. Shannade claimed that she didn't find out that James, her quote-unquote sugar daddy, was dead until later. However, over the next few months after his death, she went on a $20,000 shopping spree, using his card to pay for her rent, purchase flights, and splurge on Valentino shoes and a long list of other luxury items. Furthermore, Shannade created a fake email in James's name, and she made a Western Union account. She then initiated a wire transfer of $1,000 to herself. Crazy, right? Shannade was indicted on three felony counts, including wire fraud, access device fraud, and aggravated identity theft. She was potentially facing a total of 42 years in prison. She pled guilty only to wire fraud, and she made a deal to have the other two charges dropped. Shannade was sentenced to a one-year sentence for wire fraud in April of 2019. She was released from prison on March 5th of 2020. She posted an emotional video on her Instagram page of her reuniting with her sister after being locked up for nearly a year.
Come on the door.
That was a touching reunion. Since Shannade's release, the twins have been active on most of their social media platforms. Comment below and tell me your thoughts about the Shannade Clermont fraud case.
Everybody want this cookie. My spoil your rotten cookie.